living in the yurt wasn't our first house. We decided to convert a van that we got from this beach hill like that into a kind of mini RV.
Yeah. That was fun.
So living in that van for a month or two, that was that.
It was challenging.
Okay, let's go get a mattress.
When we got the van, it already had the back all open. There was no seats, nothing. So that was really nice. So it made it easier for us to just kind of put a little bed platform in there. And then we just got a pillow top, like a memory foam pillow top, and put it on there and bought a boom. We got some totes to go underneath, store our food.
Yep.
That's about it. Boom, home.
Yeah. And the most challenging part of this entire journey, I think, for us, but especially for you, is what part of it?
Not being close to my family and my friends. I'm a huge people person, and I'm really close to my family. Starting over. What exactly does that mean? There's absolutely nothing on this property except for what you see. Trees. Sticks and mud and rocks and dirt and soil and all of that. There's no shower, there's no toilet, there's no house, there's nothing, absolutely nothing. It is raw. Jake and I decided that we are going to build a yurt. So yeah, so here we are, starting over. Episode 1, off-grid or living off-grid with Jake and Nicole.
We decided to drive to Como Ready in the winter time during like a winter blizzard.
Yeah.
How was the drive up?
Oh, it was so scary.
Of course, friends and family, but the hardest part for you about this whole journey has been the boat access only nature of this project.
Yes, it's really stressful.
We brought a cardboard here to get ourselves out of the rain, our van, belongings, and the yurt. But they had to come by barge on the ocean. So what was that like?
It was really stressful, and it was really fascinating to see how the locals do that here. But yeah, it was different. You had to think differently of how to get things here.
We went from like a moving truck to the barge, and then we had to unload everything on the dock. And then we still had to get everything from the dock to our property at night till midnight.
It was, yeah, kind of scary, actually.
It was scary. When we finally got here, where were we living at that time?
In a van.
But on this old abandoned, like, dirt road.
Oh, yeah. We were just on this road.
Don't let Joe Biden tax away your rights.
That's funny. You elect me, I'm not going to have any taxes because the grain's not cut.
Especially if you were a gun owner. Joe Biden's plan? Confiscate your firearms unless you pay up. He could cost you thousands to keep your guns. Don't let Joe Biden tax away your rights.
Why aren't there more people who look like me in government?
How can I change things where I live?
Change begins with a question. So City Foundation is supporting Girl Scouts as they empower young leaders through civic education to help create a better tomorrow.
And then we had to quickly get buildings and basic necessities of life, like compost toilets, outdoor showers, things like that.
Yeah.
Okay, so the first thing that we had to do when we were here was get the yurt here, get the cardboard here, get our van here that we live in, and then get a boat. Okay, what did you get?
We got the Striker Hunter Jet 420.
Yeah, 13 and a half foot. It's got a 20 horsepower outboard engine on it, outboard motor. And Striker's cool because they're a British Columbian company. So we,
on the way up here, that's when we picked it up.
And the Striker is kind of like a little BMW convertible. It's like fast, puts you right down there with the elements. And
oh, yeah.
We've used it for almost everything. We've brought everything that we needed. With that Striker boat to this property.
Yeah. It's a super nice boat, and it's been very helpful compared to the first boat that we thought was going to
Cookie's probably like, hey, pay attention to me over here.
Still needed a lot of work, right? It still had a lot of alder, a lot of salmonberry, and it still had to be cleared. It took us weeks.
Oh yeah, it's still very bushwhacky.
You did the first one. You're so cute.
Stage one is getting the stuff here. We got that waterproof. Stage two is getting a place cut in. But I mean, it's going to rain here, and we are so lucky to only have one night of snow. The rest has been sunny. We've got to have rain protection, and we got an easy build structure.